Good morning. Welcome to the session. In the previous session, we had discussed about the security concerns of system administrator and what are the privileges that was given to the system administrator. In this session, we shall discuss about the duties of your system administrator with respect to user management. Your system administrator has a provision to add or delete a user or a group from the system. As a part of it, we have three different types of accounts on a Unix system. They are root account, system account, user account. So with respect to this root account, so this root account is also called a super user's account, which has a complete control of the system, where a super user can run any commands without any restrictions. The second type of your account is system account, where this system accounts are usually needed to perform some specific functions on the system, and such as maintaining and managing the mail accounts. And the very important point is, if any modifications are done to a system account, it might adversely affect the system. So we should be very careful whenever we are making any alterations to the system account. The third type of your account in the Unix system is user account, where this account provides an interactive cases to the system, both for the users as well as for the groups of users. And we also have a special type of an account called as a group account, which is logically groups where a number of users exist. So every account would be a part of any group account. The importance of having your group account, this plays a major role in handling the file permission and process management. So in the next part, we shall see how do we manage the users and groups. As a part of it, we have three main user administration files, and these administration files which we have discussed in the previous session. One is etc password, which can store the password. The second one is etc shadow. The third one is etc group. So we'll discuss one by one. So this etc, this is a file. Etc followed by a password is a file which keeps user's account and password's information. So majority of the information about an accounts on the Unix system is stored in this particular password. The second type of administration file is etc followed by the shadow, where this file will hold the encrypted passwords of corresponding account. So most of the systems may not support this type of files in Unix. The next type of administration file that what we have is etc followed by group. This file contains the group of information for each account users. And we also have a special type of administration file, that is etc followed by g shadow. So here g represents the group. This file contains the secure group accounts information. So the difference is, this will hold an encrypted password of a corresponding account, and this particular file will contain the secure group account information. So we have some of the commands available in the Unix system that will help to create and manage both accounts and groups. So that we will see. So here we have the several commands that can create and manage accounts as well as the groups. They are, the first one is user add. This particular command will add accounts to the system. The second one is user modification. This particular command, user mod, is a user modification that modifies the account's attribute. The third command what we have is user delete, user DEL, which deletes an account from the system. And the fourth command what we have is group add, helps to add the groups to the system. And the next one is group mod, which represents group modify, which modifies the group attributes. So here it modifies the user's attribute, and this will modify the group attributes. The last command that what we have is a group delete. If I would like to remove a group from the system, then I'm going to make use of group delete. Now we will be discussing first three commands which will help you to create and manage the account for an individual user. So this responsibility is taken care by your system administrator. The first one is, how do we add a user account? So there are two different ways where an account can be added. One is using the shell script, or we can edit the file called as etc password. So here is an example where we make use of our VI editor to add the respective user account into a file called as etcpasswd. So rather than going with the shell script, we are going to make use of a text editor using VI, and we are going to add this particular information or an information of a user in the file called as etc/passwd. So here we have an example, dept1 double colons 1052 department of BCA, and we have a directory here and followed by a shell. So what is this? So this dept1 represents the login name, and these two colons represents a blank, which means that there is no password. That means when you are trying to add any password, or you are going to insert any user's account using a VI editor, basically we don't specify with the password, we just leave it as a blank. So the first part is a login and the second part is password, but the password is not been specified here. And the third part is the user ID, fourth one is the group ID, and the fifth one is the complete description or the information of a particular user, and this is your home directory, and the last one is user's shell. So this entire thing is being added into a file called as passwd using your VI editor. Once this has been added to the file called as passwd, now we have to ensure that the complete information should be present in a particular directory called as dept. Now this entire addition of an information is done before creating a directory. So how do we do that? So we first have to create a directory called as department, which is your home directory. Once your directory called as department is being created, now I would like to change the owner and the group. So most of the times the super user which has created the directory called as this dept, the owner and the group of this directory will be its the root itself will be acting as both owner as well as the group. So it is our responsibility, or it's a responsibility of a super user, to change both the ownership as well as the group of your directory called as department. So what we do is, so here the owner for this particular user dept is root, and the group owner is also this dept, for dept is root itself. So we have to change it. So how do we change it? We have a command called as a change owner. Now change the owner which belongs to a directory called as dept from your root directory to dept1. Now the basic owner, when the directory is being created, the owner for your directory dept is root itself. The owner itself is root. Now what I have to do is, I have to convert your owner root from the respective user's name which is present in the directory called as dept. So change the owner to department1, which lies in the home directory called as dept. Very similar to that, we should also change the group owner from root to required group owner name. So here I'm going to make use of chgrp, where this will change the group owner from root to csc, which exists in our directory called as dept. So here we are going to change the owner called as dept. The actual owner, whenever the directory is created, the actual owner would be the root, and the group owner will also be the root itself. So I would like to change both the user as well as the group ownership. So how do we do that is using chown. This is going to change the owner from root to dept1, which lies in the directory called as dept, and we also change the group ownership from root to CSE, which exists in a directory called as dept. So this is how we add. So the first part is we have to append this content into the file called as /etc/password, and then create a directory called as dept, and then change the ownership and group ownership from root to the respective ownership and to the respective group ownership. So this is how we add a user account as a system administrator. So we'll move on to the next one. How do we create an account? So creation of an account can be done through a shell script here. So we have seen a command which will help us to create an account. So to create an account, I'm going to make use of a command called as userAdd, and this is your general format of your userAdd, which will help you to create an account. We have -d, then home directory, -g, then group name, -m, -s, shell, -u, user ID and account name. So where user ID is the command, where -d specifies the home directory from the account, then this is your home directory, the actual home directory which you have to specify. Then -g represents, which specifies a group account for this particular account. Then you have to, this is your group name. So -d home directory specifies home directory for an account, -g gname specifies a group account for this particular account, where -m, if a directory does not exist, it helps you to create the home directory. -m helps to create a home directory if the directory does not exist. Then -s specifies the default shell for this particular account, -s followed by the shell. Then -u user ID specifies the user ID for this particular account and the actual account name which has to be created. So here we have an example here. So userAdd is a command which we used, and I have to specify the home directory for the account using -d. So this is my home directory called as ncms. Then I have to specify my group name using -g. So the group name is ngi, where this -2 specifies the account, this shell's account number, and this is your shell part. And finally bca is the account name which I have to create. Here -m, which helps you to create a home directory, is not mandatory. If the directory does not exist, then this will help us to create the directory. Now let me assume that my directory called as home ncms already exists, so I'm not going to make use of -m, and specifying the user ID is also not mandatory. If required, your Unix will help you to provide a user's user ID, and both -m and -u is not mandatory. If required, we can use or we can leave. So here I have not used either -m or I have not specified to create a user ID. So I am going to create an account name called as a BCA, which where your directory is ncms and your group name should be ngi. So before executing this particular command, make sure that there should be an existence of a group called as ngi. If you do not specify this particular group, then that leads to an error. So once this particular command is been executed, it creates an account called as a BCA. So now a user called as an BCA is been created. So now what we can do is, I would like to set my password to this particular user account called as a BCA. So what I do is, I will type a command called as passwd, and specify my user ID or your login ID. Now this will ask you to change the password for user BCA. Now you can enter the new password and confirm your new password by retyping this. So once you set your password successfully, then it gives a message called as all authentication tokens are updated successfully. So this is how you can create an account through a shell script. So the next part is, how do we manage or modify a user account? So here we have a example for that. Now what am I going to do is, so user mode mod represents modify, and this is your directory name called as ncms, and hyphen m, as we know that it is used if the directory called as ncms does not exist, then it creates a directory called as ncms where hyphen m is not mandatory. Now what am I going to do is, I'm going to modify the user account. The previously created account is BCA. Now I'm going to make use of hyphen l to change the user account from BCA to CS. So very simple, where we use user mod to change the user's account which exists in the directory. If the directory does not exist, then we can make use of hyphen m to create a new directory and make use of hyphen l to change the user's account from an existing account to a new account. So here BCA is an existing user account which has been modified from BCA to CS. Now the actual user account was BCA, now it is being changed from BCA to CS. So the next command or the operations with respect to your user management is, how do we remove a user account? So a very simple operation we have a command called as user del, so where hyphen r represents to remove and followed by our account. So this command can be used to delete an existing user. But the thing is, whenever we perform this operation, you should be very careful in removing this particular user from your file called as etcpasswd. If you remove it, it may result in some adverse effect. Now we have one more command called as rm, which we have discussed in the previous sections, that is remove directory itself. So if I would like to remove the directory itself, then the entire directory called as dept is removed along with its user, because in the directory called as dept we have a user account called as bca. Remember one thing, this hyphen r is not mandatory. An option what we use as hyphen r is to remove. So if I omit this hyphen r option, then this will help us to keep our home directory for backup purpose. That means your file BCA will not be completely removed, but it will be kept as a backup file in the Unix file system. But when you make use of hyphen r, your account, user account called as BCA, will be completely removed from your system. If you don't use your hyphen r, just specify user del and followed by BCA, or with respect to your directory called as dept, this will keep your directory or your user account for the sake of backup purpose. So in the next session we shall discuss about the startup, how do we start up and how do we shut down, and how do we provide a backup and restore in Unix file system, and how this has been handled by your system administrator. Thank you.